Mary T. Meagher, known worldwide as Madam Butterfly, has dedicated herself to becoming the greatest butterfly swimmer of all time. At the 84 Olympics, Mary T. attained her goal as she became a triple gold medal winner, including victories in the 100 and 200 meter butterflies. But perhaps her most cherished moment was at the 79 U.S. Nationals at age 14. She set two world records and received worldwide acclaim.
At the time, I didn't even know I had set the world record. It wasn't something I'd set out to do. But, Mary T. Meagher, the world record holder, was always this other little girl. And I had my own life to live. I just went to school and didn't, you know, play with my friends.
Mary T. has grown up and still lives in Louisville, Kentucky. Her hometown has recognized Mary's achievements by naming a natatorium in her honor.
The sign still shocks me. Every time I drive past it and I see this huge sign, Mary T. Meagher Natatorium, I'll have to admit, I'll probably appreciate it a lot more once I'm away from the sport a little longer and realize what a big honor that was that they bestowed on me after 1984.
Mary's inspiration has been drawn from the structure of her large family, consisting of her parents, nine sisters, and one brother. When not training, Mary T. often turns to her family. She relaxes with her brother and sisters and her nieces and nephews.
I hope I'm blessed with a lot of kids myself, although that probably won't come for a while longer. I think that's where I'm going to get the same satisfaction out of life that I've gotten through my swimming. But I think in working with kids is where another of my talents lie. And I think I'll feel real satisfied if I use that talent up to its fullest.
Inasmuch as Mary T. has attained Olympic gold and lofty heights, the pressure to win at Seoul and stand on the victory platform has lessened. While training this past year, Mary includes more recreation in her life, more time to dance and party with her friends.
If things don't go well in Seoul, I don't think, I mean, I'll be disappointed, but at least I'll always be able to say that I did it before. And that's real nice. It will relieve a lot of the pressure in Seoul. And I'll be standing up on the block, hopefully with more to win than to lose.
At age 23, 7 years after setting her last world record, Mary T. Meagher may be too old by swimming standards.
Maybe possibly I am past my prime, not only physically but mentally. I have a lot harder time motivating myself and to want the same things that I wanted. But even physically, it takes me a lot longer to recover from workouts day to day, and it takes a lot less to wear me down.
Three gold medals, two world records, more than 20 U.S. championships. Mary T. Meagher, most dominant in her sport, reflects on past successes and looks forward to her new challenges.
That's a look at one of the greatest swimmers of all time, Mary T. Meagher. Well, she finished seventh in the 100-meter butterfly a few days ago, and she's ready now for the 200 meters. Let's go now to Don Crickey and John Neighbor at the Olympic Park swimming pool.
Welcome back to the Olympic Park swimming pool. We're about now ready for the gold medal swim in the women's 200-meter butterfly, featuring Mary T. Meagher of the United States, the lady who set her first world record at age 14, and now at age 23, ready for her last Olympic swim. Her mark set in 1981 in the 2 and 100-meter butterflies are the standards by which everyone in this sport is still judged. Nobody's challenged those records yet, John.
Not even Mary T. In fact, I think we all sense the end of an era, as Mary T. will probably go out in a blaze of glory. This is the swan song for Madam Butterfly. Sounds sort of like a greatest hit package for an opera or something, but this will be her final farewell. We thought that she wasn't going to do real well because she seemed to be so lighthearted the entire time in Seoul. She's not been training that hard or as disciplined as these Germans have, but we saw a spark of fire in her in the preliminaries. She came on like gangbusters just in time to win her heat. And perhaps she'll use that spark and that natural talent that's done so well for her to bring her a final gold medal, bringing her Olympic total to 4.
She's one of 11 children, and a good part of them, our contingent, is here to back Mary T. in her final swim. That's one of her sisters there, and her husband. Her mother and dad are up there, Jim and Floyd, ready to see Mary T. go for it one more time in the Olympic Games. Made her first Olympic team at age 15. There she is, one of the leaders in the sport in America in women's swimming. There's her world record time. Actually, one of the most outrageous world records ever. I mean, nobody has ever even been close. As you pointed out, John, not even Mary T. She did it in a, what wasn't considered that fast a pool in Milwaukee.
It was at the U.S. Nationals, Don, and her winning time beat half of the men in the same event that year.
There's the field. Trina Radke will swim for the USA in lane one. 17 years old, living there in Allentown, Pennsylvania. Stella Pura, a 17-year-old from Romania, swims in lane two. Mary T. Meagher swims in lane three. Kathleen Nord from East Germany, perhaps the swimmer to beat. In lane four, if she's not, Birte Weigang is, another East German. Connie Van Benten from Holland swims in lane six. Takashi from Japan will be in lane seven. And Sia Hong from China will be in lane eight. Final heat, the gold medal swim in the women's 200-meter butterfly.
This has got to be a sweet and sour moment for Mary T. To go out at the Olympic level and the Olympic championship final is thrilling. So much has always been expected of her ever since she set that record 7 years ago. And she's often indicated she's not the same woman she was 7 years ago. She was a girl then. She's a woman then.
She's a threat to win every time she goes in the water in a highly competitive situation, and this is the ultimate. And right now, the first start is a good one. They come out stroking, and Mary T, three down from the top, comes out stroking well along with Birte Weigang, who's in lane five for East Germany.
One of the things Mary T does so beautifully is she keeps herself close to the surface of the water, not wasting energy, coming high and then dropping too deep. She can swing her arms around in a beautiful recovery. It's really a textbook butterfly. Three down from the top of the screen. Mary T. Meagher.
Weigang establishing a very fast pace, faster than a world record pace, as Birte Weigang of East Germany has extended now to a full-length lead over the nearest swimmer, Mary T. Meagher.
This is Mary T. You see her in the center of the screen as she swings her arms around. She's looking up a little bit, and she's really a lot stronger towards the end of the race, so don't be too concerned at this point, but she's going to have to start making up that ground soon.
Birte Weigang, the leader from East Germany, as they come to the halfway point, is known for her first half swims. She is still under the world record time through the halfway point of this women's 200-meter butterfly. That's Mary T. Meagher, who is swimming well back now, about two lengths back, as Weigang pours it on, 20 years old.
Mary T's making a run for it now. She's starting to throw her hands a little bit more quickly and a little bit stronger kick.
Mary T is making up ground. Mary T. Meagher swimming in lane three. She's out almost 2 seconds faster than her swim this morning. So Maher's really throwing in a good one in her final run in the Olympic Games. And now they come to the final turn. Birte Weigang of East Germany is in the lead. Mary T. Meagher is swimming to the left of your screen. She is in third place at the moment. Weigang holding on. Kathleen Nord of East Germany in lane four, starting to move up on her East German teammate. Mary T is running third right now. She's in position to medal, and she'll really have to kick in to catch him at the end, as the two East Germans have too much on her with 10 meters to swim. And now for Mary T. Meagher, it's a fight to the finish. Can she win bronze? It looks like she might, as East Germans go 1-2, and Mary T. Meagher medals in her final swim.
And the winning time is absolutely nowhere near Mary T's world record. So the young girl from 7 years ago would have won this race handily by about three and a half seconds.
Kathleen Nord of East Germany just touched out her teammate, Birte Weigang, who led almost the entire race. Touched her out at the finish line, and there's Kathleen Nord, thrilled to win gold, overcome with emotion. Weigang gets silver, and Mary T. Meagher, in her final swim, gets a bronze medal for the USA.
She's going to come over and congratulate the winners. You might well imagine that. Nord on top, Weigang on the bottom. It was 0.5 seconds differential for the gold and silver. It really was pretty much a one woman race at the start. Weigang took control, and then Nord chased her down. You can imagine how it's like for mom and dad to be watching from the stands as Mary T goes for a fourth medal in her third Olympic team. There's only four women who've ever won, made three Olympic teams.
There's Team Meagher in the stands now. Up and cheering Mary T as she comes to the line. Since she was 8 years old, she's been a great one when she started to train on a regular basis. And Mary T's career concludes. Her world record, to give you an idea, Nord, the winner here, was about 4 seconds over it. Kathleen Nord wins, Weigang is second, Meagher third in the women's 200-meter butterfly.